So as you can see, it has returned the date and time of the log, and also it has returned the current Google map location of that person. And you can see that we have got the map, Google map location of that person, and have an accuracy of 21 meters. What's up guys, and welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to actually track anyone's location using your own device. Irrespective of its operating system, such as Android or Windows, you can actually track anyone's location from your own device. So what we are going to do is that we are not actually tracking the IP based location of that person. We are actually going to track the exact GPS location of the person. So we are actually using a tool which actually made here inside NAB Lab. We made the tool, so it has its own demerits and all, but it can do the job. So before we get started, first of all, go ahead and subscribe and like to my channel, otherwise this tool is not going to work for you. Second of all, please don't you do it for any illegal or privacy threatening stuff. If you use it for any illegal purposes, there will be noise knocking on your door saying
FBI, open up!
So please don't do that. So with that being said, let's get started.
A few moments later.
So guys, this is the tool that we have made here. This is a NAB location tracker. So basically what this does is that it will actually track that person's exact GP location and actually save it in the user.txt file. So let me just go ahead and demonstrate and show you what it actually does. So now let me just go ahead and clone this to my desktop. Stop. Click clone. We are in, and let me just run and show you what this application does. So now it's running, and let me just go to the URL and see that in action. You can see press allow to continue, and it will ask for your location, and if I allow, it will actually redirect to me to the original Google site. Here we are. Perfect. Now if I go back to the directory of NAB Lab, let me just go and stop this. And if I go ahead and inside the directory of NAB Lab, you can see user.txt file. If I just use it to see the, so as you can see, it has returned the date and time of the log, and also it has returned the current Google map location of that person, and it has also returned the Google its accuracy, the radius of in which the person might be in. So you can see it's a really bad accuracy. That's because I'm using it in a laptop, but if you're using it in a Android device or mobile phone, it will actually has a pretty good accuracy, like a 20 meter accuracy. So let me just go ahead and show that inside my phone. So guys, I have already opened in my mobile device over here. Sorry, because I can't show you that because I'm filming my phone. So let me just go ahead and show that what I got. So CD, okay, cat, user.txt. And as you can see, I have got a Google map location link over here, and with an accuracy of 21 meter. You can imagine we have an accuracy of 21 meter. So let me just go ahead and show this place. Just go ahead and copy that and paste it on my Google over here. As you can see, it's loading up Google Maps, and you can see a place, and it's the exact location of my place. So that's it. Let me just go ahead and show you how to do this. So in the second part of this video, I'm going to show you how to actually deploy this using your mobile device or your PC or whatever you have. So if you're into really good programmer, or you know to code, or you have a Linux machine, it will be really easy for you to actually deploy and use it in your own PC. But it becomes handy if you really deploy it on Pythonanywhere servers. So let me just go ahead and show you how to deploy this web app on Pythonanywhere server. So guys, welcome to the part 2 of this video. So I'm going to show you how to actually deploy my site or the tool on our Pythonanywhere server. You can use actually Android device or Windows machine for doing this. So I'm going to demonstrate this on a Windows machine. So first of all, go inside the link provided in the description, a GitHub link. So now download as zip, and it'll be downloaded. So let me just go ahead and open the file directory. Here we are. So let me just go ahead and extract that, extract all, and extract here. So perfect, I have extracted the zip file, and this is the files inside the zip folder. So guys, after doing this, we have to go to pythonanywhere.com. So here we are, you can see a page like this. So speaking about Python Anywhere servers, it is actually a free server actually used for running and hosting our Python web applications. So start running Python online in less than in a minute. So and then you can see a page like this, a beginner free plan, or you can have a good domain name and have good specifications of the web server using some of the subscriptions, but I will go with a free beginner account. So then you will be redirected to a page like this. You can create a new username. I will go with Google Ad Lead Services, and I will give a dummy email, dummy123@gmail.com, and I will actually give a legit password so that I can re-log in again if I want. So I agree and register. So there we are, we have created a web server. Enter, and you can see a page like this saying dashboard, and it will actually show you the CPU usage, the file storage and all. But I am interested in creating a web app, open web app. Then you can see you have no web apps, so here I have to create one. So let me just go ahead and add a new web app. So your web app's domain name will be Google Ad Lead Services.pythonanywhere.com. So not a problem. So the tool is actually made on Flask. So I will actually go with Flask Python 3.7 and next. If you don't know something, or if you have something trouble with this, just put it on default. So you can see all done, your web app is now set up, details below. And if you put this link on the browser, you can see hello from Flask. Perfect. Now we must be careful for what we are going to do here. So let me just go inside my site code directory, and you will see a file named flaskapp.py. So go ahead and open that. You will see something like this. We have to change the source code for this application to be this app file. So let me just go ahead and open this app, and so here we are. Let me just go ahead and copy that and paste directly over here and save that. Don't forget to press save, otherwise the work will be lost. So let me just go back. Now let me go inside the home directory of Google Ad Lead Services. So let me just go ahead and create a new dirt new templates. So a new directory. There we are. So now we have to do is that upload a file. So it will be inside the templates folder index file. So it's actually made inside the Google Ad Lib services. So if I go back, you can see templates folder is here, my site folder is over here. Perfect. Now we have to upload one more file, which is user.txt file. So this will be this one. Perfect. Now you can see we have uploaded every files. So let me just give a walk around what we have done here. We have uploaded the user.txt file on the home directory inside our main folder, Google Ad Services, and we have also changed the source code for the site inside flask app.py, and we have also created a new folder named templates, and we have uploaded the index.html file to the folder. So now basically what you want to do is that go to web, reload the Google led IO services. You'll actually reload and write the changes you have done. So let me just go to the URL, and you'd like to say internal server. Why is that? To know the errors you have in your web application, go to error log and it will show you the error. Template not found. Oh yes, I have done a pretty much mistake, but sorry for that. I have actually created the templates folder in the main working directory. I have to actually create the templates folder inside my site. Sorry for that. Now we have to create a templates folder. Templates folder, new directory. And now we have to upload a file, which is the index.html file. Perfect. Now let me just go ahead and reload the web application again, and let me see the changes. So let me just reload this page and see. You can see press allow to confirm, and it is not showing us the location button for allowing, right? That is because we haven't toggled the force HTTPS option over here. Let's toggle that on and again reload the web application. So guys, we have reloaded the page, and now let me just go ahead and refresh this page. And you can see it's now HTTPS and it is asking your location. Press allow and it will actually redirect to the original Google page. Now let me just go ahead and show you where the location is saved. It's inside this home directory inside Google led ad services inside user.txt, and you can see the location and the accuracy. Perfect. Let me just show you how to actually change the redirecting URL. So let's go inside the working directory inside the my site inside templates. Let's go inside the index.html, and you can see https google.com. if you go ahead and change that to like https say like flipkart.com or something, flipkart.com. And if I go ahead and save that, make sure you reload the web app. You can actually reload the web app from here directly. So guys, let me just go ahead and show you the its work inside the mobile device. So let me just go ahead and paste the URL and go, and you can see press allow to continue, and as you can see it directly actually redirected to the flipkart.com's official site, and the user will not, or the victim will not know what actually happened over here. So now if we go back to the Python Anywhere server, let me just go ahead inside the user.txt file, and you can see that we have got the map, Google map location of that person, and have an accuracy of 21 meter. So that's it. So guys, thank you for watching. Make sure that you subscribe and like this channel. Also, if you have any issues or doubts regarding what I have done here today, just put on the comments. I will be replying that. So our new video will be coming up real soon. So until then, ciao.